Knowledge Acquisition Program. After an ELA student reaches a certain level of proficiency in English, they need to make some decisions about their next steps. There are several options right here at Pitt Community College to further your education and improve your job skills. With me this morning is Charles Newkirk, instructor in welding technology here at Pitt Community College. Good morning.
Good morning.
And thanks for being with me this morning. And you're an instructor in welding technology. In the welding program, there are licenses, diploma, and even an associate's degree. Could you tell me about the program and the different certificates available?
Okay, so in our certificate program, students can come in and get a number of different certificates, and it only takes them one semester to receive these certificates. In the diploma program, we usually don't advise guys to take the diploma. We like for them to go for the degree, because once they get to the diploma, then all they have left is the advanced classes. Mm-hmm. And so we advise them to go for the whole two-year degree program.
And what are some of the certificates available to students?
You have certificates. We have a basic SMAW, which is shielded metal arc welding. We have a basic GTAW, which is gas tungsten arc welding. And we have a basic GMAW, which is gas metal arc welding. These are three of the most common welding certificates we have available. You can also get a certificate in blueprint reading as well.
And then what are the requirements for a student if they want to just take one certificate class? What would they need to do? Do they have to enroll with the college and take the placement test?
No placement test is required for a certificate. You don't even have to have a high school diploma.
Okay.
Only if you're going for the degree. But once enrolling, we advise students to have a conversation with a welding instructor so they can know exactly what it is they're signing up for.
And you said that they don't need a high school diploma. They could take certificate classes slowly, so maybe one certificate per semester if they would like.
They can take one certificate per semester. They can take them at night. They can even come in on Saturdays. They have a number of options that are available to them.
Okay. And what about, you're also the instructor for a continuing education class being offered. What kind of classes are available for continuing ed?
We've just recently had one, all Hispanic class that we did on a Saturday. A lot of the company con ed classes are done Monday through Friday in the evenings. And our continuing education class for the all Hispanics was done on Saturday.
So once a student gets into the welding program, what is the curriculum like?
Well, our curriculum is a little different than more of the other departments here on campus. We do 15%. Probably around 15% in the classroom, around 85% lab. Most of our classes are hands-on, with the exception of a few. Blueprint reading, which would be 90-95% classroom. Inspection testing, which would be 90-95% classroom. And then symbols and specifications. For the majority of our other classes, students will be in their booths, actually grinding, welding parts together, trying to get to the point where they can pass a certification test.
Okay, so this is very much a hands-on curriculum.
Definitely a hands-on curriculum. That's why we advise students to talk to a welding instructor, because it is very physical. You have to be in great physical shape. You're going to sweat. You're going to get hot. You have to learn how to work in extreme temperatures. So we definitely want students to know what they're getting into when they sign up for welding.
Mm-hmm. Let's say you have an English language learner in your program. What are some of the obstacles they might face?
There were, in the past, some language barriers there, communicating with these guys. But now we've kind of broken that barrier. We have so many Hispanic-speaking guys who are bilingual, mm-hmm. who can speak English and Spanish fluently. And so they're able to help us with guys who come in who may not be able to speak English as fluently. Example, I have a guy from my all-Hispanic class on Saturdays who comes in during the week to get extra welding in. English is not as good. He can't understand me as well, but we have four or five other guys just waiting to translate for him.
And for some of the certificates, a student, you said that they have stick welding, mm-hmm. and what are some of the different skills that they'll be learning?
Some of the different skills they'll be learning, we have three levels of the GTAW, which is gas tungsten arc welding. We have three levels of GMAW, which is gas metal arc welding. We have three levels of SMAW, which is shielded metal arc welding. All right, these are the three basic welding processes that they will learn uh-huh. while here at Pitt Community College. We have an intro class, a plate class, and a pipe class in those three processes. They'll learn cutting processes. They'll learn how to work on different various materials, aluminum, carbon steel, stainless steel, and a few more. And they'll learn automation welding. We perform robot training to a few local companies here in Eastern North Carolina, and we hope that other local companies in the region begin to use automation robot in the near future.
And then for, when I think of welding, I think of guys and having to be really strong to work with the materials. What about women in the workforce?
Women definitely play a huge part in welding. We have about seven students here who are doing very well. We have one student in particular who's working part-time at the Roberts Company while she's completing her degree here. Mm-hmm. And she's actually the best student we've sent down there out of 10 guys. We have one female instructor who has over 25 years of experience in the field. So women definitely play a huge part in what we do over here in the welding department.
Okay. And you had mentioned employment. What does employment, what are the opportunities here in Pitt County for students after they get some of these credentials or the diploma or even the degree, what are their job prospects?
About 90 to 95% of our graduates receive employment when they finish here at Pitt Community College. One reason is there's such a huge demand, high demand for welders out in the field. There's just not enough of them. We work well here, the faculty works well here with some of the local industries, the Roberts Company, the Edwards Company, Heister Yale. So our students get a wealth of knowledge from each one of our instructors, and they're able to pretty much go out and get a job anywhere in the world.
So it sounds like a great program, and the instructors are there to support the students as they take it step by step, certificate to the diploma to degree. So thank you, Charles, for explaining about welding technology. It sounds like a great program.
Thank you for having me.
And I'm Janice Fisher with Pitt Community College's English Language Acquisition Program.